Morning, Ian Lee, BBC Three Counties Radio. Now, bogus Islamic charities are raising funds in Luton to fund criminal and terrorist activities. That's the claim of Birmingham MP Khalid Mahmood, who says some of them employ aggressive tactics. Well, it's being backed up by a report from the cross-party think tank, the Henry Jackson Society. Its author, Hannah Stuart, joins me now. Morning, Hannah.
Good morning, Ian.
So what did your report look into?
More broadly, we were actually looking into the issues, good practice, challenges that the police find when they're delivering the government counter-radicalisation strategy prevent. And one of the angles was the sort of constant work that the police do promoting safe-giving in Muslim communities, and that's really in response to, at the moment, the Syria crisis. But this intimidating form of fundraising came up within those conversations, and I was, to be honest, quite surprised by it. But I understand that Khalid Mahmood wasn't, and that he knows that this is actually quite a widespread problem, because my report looked at Bradford, but I understand that it also happens in Luton and Birmingham, where he's the MP, and that it's much more of a problem than people perhaps realise.
So what exactly, how does it work?
Well, what I heard was that, just to give an example, the collectors had buckets, labelled bucket for Syria, no identification of what charity it was, and they'd pushed the red button at traffic lights repeatedly on a busy road, back all the cars up, so that essentially, as the police said, it's a captive audience.
Oh.
People can't go away. And then they'd go down the line and quite aggressively ask for money. And in one instance, actually, the police had to record a hate crime. And so when people perhaps said they didn't want to give, or they'd given the lights previously, they'd sometimes be abused, and there were instances of accusing people of supporting the Israelis. This was during the Israel-Gaza conflict in the summer. So that's one form that's quite intimidating. And another example was that people would go to the same districts, the same houses, week in, week out, constantly asking them for money, and that the individuals living there were actually saying privately, look, we don't want to give all the time. We just don't have those funds, but we feel pressured by our sort of religious belief to give, that we're struggling to say no. And the people fundraising knew that and would take advantage of that generosity.
And are the fundraisers targeting other Muslims or anybody in general?
They're targeting other Muslim
right.
communities because of that religious injunction to give to charity.
Right.
And in the area that I was looking at, these Muslim communities were also not very wealthy. So they were targeting people under the average income level because of their generosity. So it really was a double abuse.
And if someone, you know, shakes a bucket in front of me, I can walk politely past or say no thanks or put money in if I choose to. Why are these people finding it so difficult to ignore these buckets under their nose? Is it the abuse that they're getting?
Well, in some cases, yes, particularly the traffic light case. People were genuinely being abused and with sort of quite aggressive language. But in other instances, these are close-knit, insular communities where perhaps people know the representatives of the charities or the unregistered charities, and there are reputational issues there, but there's also a cultural understanding that giving to charity is a religious obligation and the right thing to do, and that you shouldn't question it when you're asked. And that's quite a difficult issue, and it's the one that the police are trying to work with the Charity Commission to sort of alleviate. But it really is taking advantage of people's generosity.
So that's the intimidation and the threatening aspect of it. Did your report look into what Khalid Mahmood is saying, that some of these unregistered charities, they're not raising money for orphans and things like that, they're raising money for terrorist purposes?
Well, it's very difficult to know exactly where the money's going, and I guess that's what Khalid was talking about. The police, to me, were saying that the reason they work so hard to promote safe giving is that a lot of people will take advantage of these issues that we've spoken about for both criminal and terrorist intent. So they weren't able to tell me exactly where they believed the money was going, and certainly if they had concrete evidence, they would investigate. But that there's always that concern, and particularly when charities are unregistered, so they fall outside of the Charity Commission regulation.
Mm.
There can, and especially when it's labelled so vaguely, so bucket for Syria, or we're raising funds for the community, there's absolutely no indication there of where that money is going, and that for the police is a worry.
Hannah, it's fascinating stuff, and I appreciate you getting up at silly o'clock to talk to us this morning about it. That's Hannah Stuart from the cross-party think tank, the Henry Jackson Society.